Yes, sir, I realize that. But think of the disastrous effect this may have on the morale of the American teenager. No, I'm not saying the boy doesn't want to go in the army. It's just... No, I'm not trying to... 2 weeks from today, at the induction center, he'll be there. Oh, Rose, thank God you've come. This is the end of the Almalu Music Corporation. Conrad Birdie's going into the army.
And your faithful secretary is hereby submitting her resignation.
Huh?
I just dropped in to say goodbye, Albert, darling. Lots of luck.
Rose, you can't leave. Not today, of all days. Where are my pills? You know, the little white ones I take when I'm overwrought.
Here. Albert.
Not so much. Break it in half.
Albert, you are 33 years old. You can take a whole aspirin.
I am not 33. I'm a long way from 33. I won't be 33 till tomorrow. What?
Albert, it's no use. My mind is made up. I've been with Almalu for 8 long years now, and you know just as well as I do that I've been a lot more than just a secretary to you.
Rose, those were moments of madness.
Well, in between moments of madness and hours at the office, I put in a good 90-hour week. And for what? $5 raise in 1954 in a bottle of Arpège last Christmas.
Promise her anything, but give her Arpège. Come on, Rose!
Yeah, but not a 16th of an ounce. Besides, I want something more than that.
If you're talking about something of a more permanent relationship between you and me, I'm not ready for it. And besides, there are religious differences.
Spanish is not a religion.
And if it's part of the company you're after, it's no to that too. Almalu is me, Mama, and Lou. And any change in it would kill that wonderful woman who bore me.
Albert, nothing could kill your mother. Except maybe a silver bullet. Besides, it's not a part of the company I want. Something much more important.
Rose, if you're going to discuss what I think you're going to discuss, I don't want to discuss it.
Albert, there's nothing to discuss. Conrad Birdie is going into the army. I've quit, and there's nothing you can do but go back to college and get your
degree. Rose, I'm up to my ears in debt. Conrad's got a $50,000 guarantee, which I can't pay. And I've just taken a severe overdose of aspirin.
Albert, this may be your last chance. I'm serious, Albert. Are you listening to me?
Oh.
His going in the army is the best thing he could do. Now you're free to start to do what you wanted to. Albert, Albert, Albert. I remember how you told me I should trust you for a year. It would just be for a year, but it's 8 years, Albert. 8 long years, Albert.
Rose, it takes time to build a business.
It was only a sideline, that's what you said. You just needed some money, that's what you said. You were going to college and get ahead. Instead of being a music business bum, you were going to NYU and become...
Oh, Rose, don't say it.
An English teacher.
No, Rose.
And furthermore, he wrote poetry.
Rose,
and in the NYU yearbook for 1952, under Albert Peterson's favorite piece of literature, do you know what it says? Little Women.
Oh, I'm ruined in show business.
An English teacher, an English teacher. If only you'd been an English teacher. We have a little apartment in Queens. You'd get a summer vacation, and we would know what life means. A man who's got his master's is really someone. How proud I'd be if you had become one. It could have been such a wonderful life. I could have been Mrs. Peterson, Mrs. Albert Peterson, Mrs. Phi Beta Kappa Peterson, the English teacher's wife. It was goodbye, Geoffrey Chaucer. Hello, William Morris. Goodbye, NYU. Hello, Al May Lou. 'Cause when you wrote Conrad's last hit, Ugga Bugga Boo, then I knew that was it. You were through with English forever. An English teacher is really someone. How proud I'd be if you had become one. It could have been such a wonderful life. I could have been Mrs. Peterson, Mrs. Albert Peterson, Mrs. Phi Beta Kappa Peterson, the English teacher's wife.
All right, Rose, I'll make a deal with you. Stay with me. Help me pay off Conrad's guarantee. And then as soon as I'm out of the red, I'll dissolve the company and go back to the academic life.
Albert, you're on.
Of course, it may take a while, but I'm sure by 1973 or 74...
Here, pick a name.
Pick what name? What are you talking about?
All right, I'll do it for you. Okay. McAfee. Kim McAfee, age 15, president and recording secretary of the Conrad Birdie Fan Club, number 2748 of Sweet Apple, Ohio. Mary, would you get me Sweet Apple, Ohio, please? The number is capital 78820, and call me right back, please.
Who's Kim, whatever her name is?
Kim McAfee, Albert, is what's going to send you back to college with the biggest hit song this business has ever heard. It's called One Last Kiss.
I've never heard of it.
You haven't written it yet. But when you do, and when that one last kiss is from Conrad Birdie in his way into the big, cold army for 2 long years, and when that one last kiss is given to one of his fans from Conrad Birdie, chosen at random, from 1,200,000 hysterical teenagers, it'll make Mr. Birdie the hottest soldier since Joan of Arc.
Rose, I'm beginning to see it. Mm-hmm. We cut the record here in New York.
Send the greasy bongo-playing car thief to Sweet Apple.
Let him kiss the kid.
And release the record. Albert, you'll make enough money to stay in college for the rest of your life.
Rose, it'll be brilliant. It's gonna be great. And I promise, as soon as all this is over, it's gonna be you and me in perfect bliss. I'll get a job teaching and... Wait a minute. Bliss? Kiss. That rhymes. I wonder if anybody's ever used it before. Who cares? It'll be great for the song. Oh, one last kiss. It gives so much bliss. What is your dentifrice? That's too clinical.
An English teacher, an English teacher. Someday he may be an English teacher. Yes? Well, Mary, all the phones in Sweet Apple can't be busy. Kim McAfee just got pinned to who? Oh, well, it doesn't matter. Just keep trying and call me right back. Then we will have such a wonderful life. Then I might be Mrs. Peterson, Mrs. Albert Peterson, Mrs. Phi Beta Kappa Peterson, the English teacher's wife.
Thank you. Penelope.
Is it true about Kim?
Penelope.
I just knew it somehow.
About the prom.
I must call her right up.
Saturday?
I can't talk to you now.
Consider
you know it.
Well worthwhile. How lovely to wear mascara
smile, a woman's smile. How lovely to have a figure that's round instead of flat. Whenever you hear boys whistle, you're what they're whistling at. It's wonderful to feel the way a woman feels. It gives you such a glow just to know you're wearing lipstick and heels. How lovely to be a woman and have one job to do. To pick out a boy and train him, and then when you are through, you've made him the man you want him to be. Life's lovely when you're a woman like me. How wonderful to know the things a woman knows. How marvelous to wait for a date in simply beautiful clothes. How lovely to be a woman and change from boys to men. To go to a fancy nightclub and stay out after 10. How lovely to be so grown up and free. Life's lovely when you're
Yes, just a minute. Kim, dear, there's a call for you. The operator says she's been trying to get through for nearly 3/4 of an hour.
Oh, all right, Doris. I'll be down in a minute.
She said it was long distance, and I can't imagine who... What did you say?
I said, all right, Doris. Well, there's no need to look so upset. It's modern to call your mother by her first name. It makes mother and daughter more like pals.
I see. And your father?
Well, I'll call him Harry, naturally. By the way, I think Harry took the news about Hugo and I rather well, don't you, Doris? Yes. This is she. Yes, I'll wait.
I don't know. Yesterday, I was a mother. Today, I'm a pal. Wouldn't you like to call me Mom? That's modern.
I am sorry, Doris, but times are changing, and you have got to go along with them, or you'll be left behind with the old folks. And by the way, Doris, have you got an extra cigarette? Because I've run out.
I'm not an old man. I was 18 in World War II.
Oh, yes. Conrad Birdie is coming here to kiss me. Doris! Mother! Mommy!
Hey, what is it? What's wrong?
It's Conrad Birdie, Mama. He's gonna kiss me!
Mommy's shoulder.
No, you don't understand.
Conrad Birdie is coming here to Sweet Apple to kiss me goodbye. Oh, Mommy, Mommy.
I never thought I'd say it, but
God bless Conrad Birdie.
We love you, Conrad. Oh, yes.
Hi, girls. Sorry I'm late. Now, let's go over the birdie spot one more time before we go down to track 5. Remember the Conrad Birdie creed, dear? No smoking until you're 14. All right, now shall we try it? 1, 2, 3.
We love you, Conrad. Oh, yes, we do. We love you, Conrad.
Little girl, you can come sing with us if you want to. What's the matter with her?
Oh, she's just sad because Conrad's going into the army, and when he gets out, she'll be too old for him.
I think she has a few good years left. Listen, why don't you girls go down to track 5 and I'll talk to her. And stay out of the bar. Hi, I'm Albert Peterson, Conrad's manager. Aw, come on now, things can't be that black. Smile! Little girl, this is an adult speaking. I order you to smile. Please? Gray skies are gonna clear up. Put on a happy face. Brush off the clouds and cheer up. Put on a happy face. Take off the gloomy mask of tragedy. It's not your style. You look so good that you'll be glad you decided to smile. Pick out a pleasant outlook. Stick out that noble chin. Wipe off that full of doubt look. Slap on a happy grin. And spread sunshine all over the place. Just put on a happy face. Put on a happy face. Put on a happy face. And if you're feeling cross and bickerish, don't sit and whine. Think of banana splits and licorice, and you'll feel fine. I knew a girl so gloomy, she'd never laugh or sing. She wouldn't listen to me, now she's a mean old thing. So spread sunshine all over the place. Just put on a happy face. Thank you. my gosh, there's our luggage. Hurry up, little girl. You better get down to track 5 if you want to see Conrad before he goes. Oh, boy. Would you get that down to track 5 on the double, please? Rosie, what are you doing?
Getting our things down to the station without any help from you, Albert.
I'm sorry, Rose. I don't suppose a generous tip would make things up.
Albert, just take your briefcase and go down to that train before any of those reporters talk to Conrad alone. You know what happened the last time.
You hold on to it, Rose. I gotta wait here for Mama.
Speaking of your mother, Albert, have you told her about dissolving Alma Lou yet?
Oh, I couldn't, Rose. Yesterday was the anniversary.
Of what?
Of Lou. 6 years ago, he was hit on the corner of 181st Street and Broadway by a loaded beer truck.
Yeah!
You suppose that's Mama?
It's either her or the all clear.
Sonny!
Mama! Oh, Mama, what's the matter?
Oh, don't worry about me, Sonny. I'm just a little faint from the subway.
Subway? Mama, I told you to take a taxi.
Taxi? What do I need with taxis? I'll leave the taxis for my successful son. A mother can ride crowded in a dirty subway, full of foreign people who wouldn't give you a seat if your life depended on it. But what's the difference? Nowadays, a mother's lower than dirt anyway. Here's the money I saved from not taking the taxi. Buy some candy with it. Who's she?
Mama, you remember Rose Alvarez from the office?
This is Rose Alvarez? Pretty little Rose Alvarez? I can't believe it! Rose! What happened? You had a sudden shock or something?
Excuse me, Albert. I think I'll go see if Conrad is here.
By all means, Miss Alvarez. Look at her, Sonny. How nice she looks. It's a wonder to me some older man hasn't snatched her off. A personable matron like that with brains and a few dollars. What a catch you'd be for a convalescent. Goodbye, Rose.
Goodbye, May.
Call me Mrs. Peterson.
Well, Mama, what I wanted to talk to you about is sort of about Rose. Maybe you better sit down.
Why? I know my sonny. He loves his mama. He isn't going to say anything that would break her heart. Go ahead, dear. What about Rose?
Well, it's about Lou also.
Lou! Where are you, Lou? Struck down by a beverage I consumed faithfully for 32 years. What about Lou?
Well, Mama, Rose thought, and I agree, that maybe I should give up Alma Lou. What's the matter?
Nothing's the matter. You've killed me.
No, Mama, you don't understand. Rose thought. I mean, she and I, we talked. And, okay, look, here's some money. Okay. Take a cab home. The subways are too crowded.
Nothing's too crowded for a mother. I'll go during rush hour. That's the worst time.
Oh, Mama.
Wait a minute. How many blocks is it after all? Only 107? I'll walk.
No, Mama.
Enjoy yourself, son. Take care. Wear your heavy coat. Be careful crossing the street. Keep your money in your inside pocket. Wear your rubbers. And eat a hot lunch.
Albert?
aren't I thought you were going to break it to her gently?
Well, actually, Rose, I didn't tell her at all. I mean, she was so upset about me leaving, I thought I'd better wait.
You mean you didn't tell her anything at all?
He's coming! Conrad Birdie's coming!
Now, you hear that? Conrad's coming. Now, we can't leave him with those reporters alone.
But, Albert, you said that I could go...
Later, Rose. Conrad needs me.
Conrad, like, how do you feel about going into the army?
How does he feel? You ask how he feels? He's much too shy to tell you, so I'll tell you how he feels. He feels brave and eager, strangely humble, proud to be a plain GI.
He will gladly face those bullets, for he's not afraid to die.
For he's a fine, outstanding, patriotic,
that's why he volunteered.
Volunteered? I thought he was drafted.
And he appealed 3 times.
Sing!
We love you, Conrad. Oh, yes, we do. We love you, Conrad, and we'll be true. When you're not near us, we're blue. Oh, Conrad, we love you.
And how about that Hollywood starlet, Conrad? Are you two engaged?
Is he engaged? Is Conrad engaged? There's absolutely nothing to the rumor he's engaged.
She's a real pal, like a sister, but it doesn't mean a thing. And that 18-carat diamond, it was just a friendship ring.
For he's a fine, outstanding, patriotic, healthy, normal American boy.
Then why was her husband so upset?
Sing! Go!
We love you, Conrad. Oh, yes, we do. We love you, Conrad, and you'll be sure.
I'll never forget Conrad's first words when he found out he'd been drafted. Golly, Mr. Peterson, he said, I wonder if I'll get assigned to one of those frontline trenches. That way I'm sure to get me one of them dirty Jerrys.
Albert!
Or whoever's dirty this time.
Oh. Hey, Mr. Peterson! Give us the real scoop. Is Conrad still drinking a lot?
Now listen here. This gossip must stop. He goes to church each Sunday and he doesn't touch a drop.
He's as decent as a minister.
Absolutely.
He's as sober as a judge. He subscribes to every charity. And his hobby's making fudge.
He's a fine, outstanding, patriotic, healthy, normal American boy.
Is it true you found Conrad in a reform school?
That is a lie. A lie through and through. I'll tell you where he came from. Here's the story, and it's true.
He was born in Indochina.
He was born in old Virginia.
Son of missionaries.
On a 1,000-acre farm.
Very poor and very hungry.
From a line of wealthy planters.
What a cruel life to bear.
Full of genteel southern charm.
Then he drifted down to
Hong Kong. Evening by the river.
To a waterfront southern.
In the moonlight they would croon.
That is where I heard him
That's
singing.
That's where Conrad started singing.
Leave that dirty Hong Kong
plantation. Watch.
States of America, both indivisible, with liberty and justice for all!
I'm going with Conrad.
But Albert, you said I could...
Rose, I gotta write his speech for him. Listen, I want you to stack the bags, bring him back to the house. And if I see a cab, I'll send it home.
Kim? Kim, before you go, could I talk to you for a minute?
Right now? Couldn't it wait? I'm in an awful hurry.
I don't think so. It's important.
You've got a Peabody. What's so important that you have to talk to her right now?
What's so important?
Well, I'll tell you what's so important. The day after I give her my pin, she goes around kissing someone else. That's what's so important. I want you to know I'm quite upset about this. I've already had several headaches and a nosebleed.
Why, Hugo, I believe that you're actually jealous of Conrad, Bertie.
Me? Jealous? Well, I'm the opposite of jealous. I'm very jealous. And I have every right to be. Kim's my steady.
Oh, that's just it, Hugo. I'm your steady. Oh, I may admire Conrad Bertie as one admires a far, distant, and unattainable ideal. But I'm pinned to you, Hugo, and I don't care how common or ordinary you are. And that's just how I'm gonna stay.
You're not just saying that to make me feel better?
I mean every word of it, Hugo. Conrad Bertie's just a fling. A steady is forever.
One boy, one steady boy. One boy to go with, to talk with, and walk with. One boy, that's the way it should be.
Of a nosebleed have utterly vanished.
You are silly to worry, Hugo. Conrad Bertie may be a great public figure, but he doesn't make me feel all dizzy and faint when I think of him. Only my steady does that. Why, even when I say his name, I don't feel a thing. Listen. Conrad Bertie. Conrad Bertie. Conrad Bertie! One boy, one steady boy, one boy to be with forever and ever. One boy, that's the way it should be. That's the way.
The boy she loves is the boy who makes her dizzy and almost faint. And lady, that boy is me!
one guy, one special guy, one guy to live for, to care for, be there for.
What's the matter?
I was just thinking of you, Albert.
Never mind thinking of me. My speech, where is it?
In the briefcase.
Well, good. Hold on to it. The mayor's almost finished speaking. Come on.
That's the way it should be.
Gymnasium.
Right, I'll make sure we have a wire to New York.
Come on, Alice. Conrad's over here.
Fred, did you bring the box for me to stand on? Come on, Mother. I'm taking you home. It's too crowded. You'll have to drag me by the hair.
Phyllis, you know the doctor said you shouldn't go out in crowds.
Shut up and keep pushing that wheelchair.
And so, it is with great pride and prejudice, as well as the usual pomp and circumstance, that I welcome you to our fair city and present you with this 14-karat solid gold key so generously donated by men at the Sweet Apple Brass Works. And as I present this key to you, Conrad Birdie... What happened? All I said was Conrad Birdie. You girls don't stop that. I can't finish my speech.
Who cares about your dumb speech? We want to hear from Conrad.
Speak to us, oh beautiful one. Tell us how you make that glorious sound that even now, in anticipation of it, has reduced me to a raging, panting, snarling, jungle beast.
You gotta be sincere.
Mrs. Carmichael, what's the matter?
You gotta be sincere.
Mr. Burden, what are you doing?
Gotta feel it here, 'cause if you feel it here, well then you're gonna be part of sound sick. here, honestly sincere. Well, man, you gotta be sincere. If you're really sincere, if you're really sincere, if you feel it in here, well, then it's gotta be right. Oh, baby. Oh, honey. Hug me. Suffer. In everything I do, my sincerity shows through. I looked you in the eye. I don't even have to try. It's automatic. I'm sincere. When I really feel that tree. When I sing about a girl, I really feel that girl. I mean, I really feel sincere. If you're really sincere, if you're really sincere, if you feel it in here, well, then it's gotta be right open. Oh, honey. Hug me. You gotta be sincere. Oh, oh, oh. You gotta feel it here. Oh, my baby, baby. Oh, my baby. Oh, yeah. Oh, my baby. Oh, yeah. Where you gonna be sincere? 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 Oh, my baby, oh yeah. Oh, my baby, oh yeah. Where you gonna be sincere? Where you gonna be sincere? My baby, oh yeah. Oh, my baby. Oh yeah, oh my baby, oh yeah, oh my baby, oh yeah, yeah,
There's a lady with slacks lying in the gutter. Who's she belong to?
Me. Leave her there.
I've got a lock of somebody's hair. I wonder if it's his.
No, it isn't, Ethel. And give me back my hat.
We love you, Conrad. Oh, yes, we do. We love you, Conrad.
It, Kim, happens to be my breakfast, and I intend enjoy it.
Your father has a right to enjoy his eggs, Kim, dear, but I'm sure he won't mind if we just quietly start clearing away a few of these other things. I know the house has been a bit hectic this morning, dear, but Kim's gone to a lot of trouble to fix a very special breakfast for Mr. Birdie, and I intend to have everything ready and waiting for him when he comes down. After all, he is a national figure, and I want to show these New York people that we know exactly how to treat a national figure here in Sweet Apple. Of course, it doesn't mean that much to me personally. But for Kim's sake, oh, are we all done, dear? Did you enjoy it? Good. Now, if you'll just hurry along.
Doris, I'm not budging from this table till I get my coffee, smoke a cigarette, and read my paper.
I'm sorry, dear. I forgot to make your coffee this morning. How about a nice, warm 7-Up?
Morning, Pop! Here's your paper. I hope you don't mind, but I've cut out a few stories about Conrad.
I have tried to run this house on a democratic basis. I have extended the privilege of self-determination to both the woman I have married and the children I have sired. The vote has been denied to no one for reasons of age, sex, or political affiliations. There has been no taxation without representation, and open covenants have been openly arrived at. Last night, I gave my room up to a guest who repeatedly referred to me as fat. Telephone calls were made on my phone to New York, Chicago, Fairbanks, Alaska, and Hong Kong. I slept in a camp cot with my feet in the fireplace and my head in an ashtray. Outside my window, three harpies shrieked, "We love you, Conrad!" 4,763 times. I have just lost 2 fried eggs. Gentlemen, the democracy is over. Parliament is dissolved. The Magna Carta is revoked. And Nero is back in town. And you don't offer an emperor a warm 7-Up.
Mr. McAfee, I hope you won't mind staying off the phone for a while. I'm expecting a long-distance call from New York.
Perfectly all right. I'll just go out and burn Rome!
Oh, Mother, what's wrong?
Nothing, dear. Your father's just excited about Conrad's being here. That's all.
He's coming! He's coming! He's coming! Mother, you go get the kids. I'll get the eggs.
All right. Girls, he's coming. You better hurry if you want to watch him eat.
Oh. I'm sorry, Doris, but we just had to come too. Well, we'll stand quietly back here.
Here he is. Here.
Me for lunch. Hey, Fats!
Now look here, Doris, about that boy.
Oh, please, Harry, he's just shy.
Well, if you ask me.
After all, Kim is only 15 and.
Daddy, please! Not in front of everybody!
I don't care who's here. No ill mannered lout is going to. You shut up.
Oh, please, Harry, the boy's our guest, and you have no right to
say. This is my house, and until you're 18... I said shut up. Until you're 18...
Daddy!
Will you please leave me alone?
Mr. McAfee, Kim, Randolph, is this the way you want 75 million Americans to see you?
What are you talking about?
You're all going to be on television with Conrad.
On television?
I just got the confirmation from New York. From Ed Sullivan himself.
You mean we're gonna be in the Sullivan Show? The Ed Sullivan Show?
That's right. They're gonna cut in on Sweet Apple at 8:05. Which is why I beg you to put aside all petty differences. To that great audience out there, you're the American dream come true. And for the free world's sake, Mr. McAfee, don't destroy that dream.
Me on the Ed Sullivan Show? Ed Sullivan. Me, Harry McAfee, appearing with Ed Sullivan.
Ed Sullivan.
Looks great, Rose.
Of course, it's been used as a movie house for the past 30 years, but I think it'll do just fine
it'll
for the
swell,
TV
Rose.
Show.
It'll be swell, Rose.
And they're sending down the lights and cameras today, and any costumes we need, we can
Rose,
use for the show.
Rose, it'll be great. Now, would you stop talking about the Sullivan Show for just a second and step into the office? There's something very important I want to tell you. It's about you and I, Rose.
You and me, English teacher.
Rose, I'm serious. I want to tell you that I'm really glad you and I are out here together. Being away from New York, Rose, has made me see things in an entirely different light. That's why I decided to write Mama and tell her that no matter what happened, I've decided to give up Almelu.
Oh, Albert, you didn't!
Yes, I did. I wrote her the day we left, which means she's had 3 days and 3 nights to get back to me, and so far, not a word.
Yeah! 3 days and 3 nights on a trailway spot. But what's the difference? I'm only a mother. And for a mother, a trailways bus is good enough.
Mama, what are you doing here?
Did you think I wouldn't come? A woman gets a letter obviously written under the influence of drugs. And she should stay at home.
Jeez.
Pay no attention. It's only a mother's tears. Dear Mom, this is to let you know that Almelu has dissolved your friend, Albert. Oh. Almelu is dissolved. Dissolve me! Who am I, anyways? A sick old woman. Probably won't last the night. All I want is a simple stone. with one word carved on it. Albert's mother. And never mind hiring a limousine to get me to the final resting place. I'll walk.
Oh, Mama.
And tell that Spanish friend of yours I forgive her. She knoweth not what she doneth.
Mama Rose is right there.
This is Rose? I can't believe it. She looks like Margo when they took her out of Shangri-La. For her own sake, Sonny, send her back to Tibet. And don't worry about finding another secretary. It so happens I met on the bus a perfect secretary. A wonderful, refined girl on her way to Akron. Only I persuaded her to get off here. Sonny, say hello to Gloria Rasputin.
Hi, Al. You're cute.
But, Mama, I don't need a secretary. I have Rosie.
What does Rosie need a job for? In a year or two, she'll be getting Social Security.
Well, listen, I don't just type.
You do other things?
I tap dance. I figured I could help you with the secretary stuff, and you can help me get into show business. Hold this, honey. May, can you sing Swanee River?
It's my favorite selection.
Get a load of this, Al.
Certainly have wonderful qualifications. but I'm used to working with Miss Alvarez. However, as you say, Mama, we are faced with a certain amount of extra work, and...
Albert, why don't you take Gloria somewhere and see how fast she can type?
Well, I do have all those extra releases to get out. And Gloria could do them, if that's all right with you, Rose.
Oh, why should it make any difference to me?
Atta girl, Rose. You keep working and I'll go with Miss Rasputin.
I'll find you a typewriter.
Do you use the touch system?
Whenever possible.
I could kill him. I could just kill him.
That's really funny, guys. Yeah. Oh, good old. That's a good joke. Hey, wait a minute. It's kind of dark. Waiter? I
'Tis a far, far better thing I do.
Thank you.
sorry, Miss Alvarez, but I'm looking for Kim McAfee. I just want to tell her that she's not to kiss Conrad Birdie on that Sullivan show tonight, because if she does, I'll... Miss Alvarez, are you all right? Miss Alvarez, it's me, Hugo Peabody. Can I do anything for you, Miss Alvarez?
Yes, Hugo, I think you can.
Into position. We go on shortly. Curtain, drop. Let's go ahead and bring those in. Mics. Let's get that set up on stage. Boom mic. Test those. Make sure everything's working. Make sure the sound's right. No, I specifically told you no black. It doesn't show up well. Come on. Get this fixed.
So, remember, your surest way to the best in color slides is to insist on the new Kodak. Now, the young man you've all been waiting to see, as you know, is just about 14 hours. One of show business's brightest talents is going off to play a very special engagement. And tonight, before he goes, he wants to leave a certain young lady with one last kiss. Ladies and gentlemen, we take you to Sweet Apple, Ohio, where a typical American family, Mr. and Mrs. Harry McAfee, and their children, Randolph and Kim, are gathered to bid farewell to a typical American soldier, Conrad Birdie.
Where's Ed?
Oh, one last kiss, give me one last kiss. You never felt like this, never felt like this. You know I need your love. Oh, 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 give me one last kiss. Oh, one more time, baby, one more time. It really is sublime, my heart is so sublime. You know I need your love. Oh, 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 give me one last kiss. Baby, give on me one last kiss. Baby, give on me one last kiss. Oh, one last kiss, give me one last kiss. You never felt like this, you never felt like this. You know I need your love. Oh, 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 give me one last kiss.
Boys of yore, say goodbye to war. Went off to war. Went off to war.
Oh, one last kiss, give me one last kiss. It never felt like this, it never felt like this. You know I need your love. Oh, oh, oh. Give me one last kiss. Oh, one more time, baby, one more time. You really are sublime, my heart is so sublime. You know I need your love. Oh, 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 give me one last kiss. Baby, give on me one last kiss. Baby, give on me one last kiss. Oh, one last kiss, give me one last kiss. You never felt like this, you never felt like this. You know I need your love. Oh, 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 give me one last kiss, one last kiss. One last kiss. Oh, give me one last kiss. One last kiss. One last kiss. Oh, give me one.
myself, Jake.
Brace yourself, Conrad! Burn!
Hugo! You hit him!
Well, he deserved it. He was a thief of love.
Hugo Peabody! I never want to see you again!
Hey, who's responsible for this? Who let that kid in here?
I did, Albert.
Rosie?
It's just sort of a farewell present for you and Miss Rasputin. Wear it in good health.
Rose, you can't leave me here alone.
Oh, you're not alone, Albert. You're on television.
For he's a fine, upstanding, patriotic, healthy, normal American boy. For he's a fine, upstanding, patriotic, healthy, normal American boy.
How long I've wasted on him. That's all. I'm through. Albert, dear, to put it sweetly, to hell with you. That's right. The hell with you, Albert. From now on, it's going to be me, Rosie, on the town, having a ball, making up for 8 long years of being in love with a mama clutching, aspirin splitting, 6-foot tower of jello. What did I ever see in him? How could I ever get involved that way? Now that it's over, I can smile and say, what did I ever see in him? Boy, I was way out on a limb. Now that I'm safely on the ground again, now that my senses have been found again, what did I ever see in him? Is he tender? No, he's not. Is he thoughtful? No, he's not. Am I crazy? What's he got that I found so damn appealing? What did he ever do for me? Well, to be honest, he was sometimes nice, but still it wasn't worth that awful price. It was rough from the start. Broken dates, broken nails, broken heart. What did I ever? How did I ever? Why did I ever?
Oh, Miss Alvarez, don't be so upset. All men can't be like that.
Every one of them. Well, except maybe Albert Schweitzer, and I'm not his type. They're all the same. From puberty to senility. From Benedict Arnold to Mussolini.
I never understood why Ingrid Bergman married him in the first place.
Egotistical, selfish human beasts.
Then what are we poor women to do, Miss Alvarez?
Use them. Let them be our playthings while we live. Sip from the cup of life and mix the potion full and strong and drain it to the dregs. How do you like them apples, Mr. Peterson?
Do we need them? No, we don't. Do we want them? No, we don't.
will we leave them?
No, we won't. Tell me, what did I say that for?
What did we ever see in them?
How could we ever think that they were nice? Take it from us, we paid an awful price. It was rough from the start. Broken dates, broken nails, broken heart. What did we ever see in
Hugo F. Peabody?
Huh?
Hugo, what did I ever see in him? Do you know he is as bad as Mr. Peterson, if not worse? Miss Alvarez, I'm coming with you.
Kim, don't be ridiculous. You're only 15.
But Juliet was 14 when she left home.
And look what happened to her. Kim, just get some milk and cookies and go to bed like
it's
a good little...
It's too late for milk and cookies, Miss Alvarez. Ugh. I want to live. We'll sip the dregs together. We'll help each other with our potions.
I'm okay, and I don't feel like getting out of bed. Now leave me alone.
Now, Conrad, be reasonable. You've had a severe shock, and the best thing for you to... Aha! There she is! It's the traitor who stabbed me in the heart while my back was turned.
Albert, no, let me...
Be careful, Sonny! She may be our...
Mom, I can handle her. You just go with Conrad and see that he gets into bed.
Conrad! Wait for me! I'll make you a nice, hot cup of Ovaltine.
Albert, for the last time, will you let me by? I'm going out on the town tonight, and I don't want to waste another minute.
Not until I've had my say, Rose. I just wanted to let you know that, thanks to Mama's quick thinking, the kiss will take place after all, tomorrow morning, just before Conrad leaves. So it looks like you failed, Rose. As anyone must fail when they tangle with Al Peterson, one of the giants, one of the titans, one of the King Kongs of the music industry.
What did I ever see in him? How could I ever think that he was nice? Take it from me, I paid an awful price. It was rough from the start. Broken dates, broken nails, broken heart.
An empire builder, a colossus.
Get out of my way, you defrocked English teacher. What did I ever see in him?
Rose, Rose, come back, do you hear me? This is King Kong calling. Rose! Rose, I need you. Rose, please. And I don't care how much you plead and beg, Miss Alvarez, you are through here at Almalu. Not only do I accept your resignation, but you're fired. And furthermore, Miss Alvarez, sticks and stones will break my bones, but names will never harm me. You big rat. Sorry to do this in front of you folks, but I've had to let Miss Alvarez go. I'll get that.
Probably Hong Kong again.
Hello? Yes, this is Albert Peterson. No, I'm sorry. Miss Alvarez is no longer with us.
Miss Alvarez, wait for me! I'm coming with you!
And where do you think you're going, young lady?
With Rosie. To drain the deep dregs and sip full hearty the brimming cup. To live!
Upstairs.
But, Daddy...
Upstairs? Do you hear me? I said upstairs.
Miss Alvarez was right. You're all the same. From puberty to milk.
liberty in front of your own father.
No!
Not to mention Mussolini. Doris, we failed as parents. I never asked much from my children, just respect. A little respect. That's all I ask for. Respect. But did I get respect? I did not get respect. I got no respect.
I respect you, Pa.
I don't want your respect. You're a child. What good is respect from a child? Doris, take me to my room. I am not a well man. Certain words I didn't want to hear in this house. Puberty was the first. Oh, and Mussolini, that was the second. And respect was the third.
Hey, now listen here, Mr. Lewis. No 3-cent reporter's gonna bulldoze me. I happen to be Albert J. Peterson, and you can print that in whatever cheap paper you happen to represent. What's that? It's not a paper, it's a magazine. And your name's not Lewis? You're Mr. Luce from Life magazine? Oh, Rose, I need you.
Where are you going?
Nowhere's, Mama, just out. It's getting stuffy in here. I'm going to look for Rosie, Mama. I love her, and I want her back.
Is that all? I thought it was something serious. By all means, Sonny, go find your Lady of Spain and bring her back here. And by the way, dear, when you get back, be sure to stop in the kitchen.
Mama, now get...
It's a strange house. I don't want to run up a bill.
Now, Mama. Now, would you stop this? If you really loved me, you'd help me come look for Rose. I mean, don't you understand? She's gone out to make up for all the years she wasted on me. Who knows what kind of low dive she's in right at this very moment.
Now, Sonny, you're right. I'll help you find her. Only maybe I better give you the message from Conrad first.
What message?
Nothing to worry about, sweetheart. He just says he's going out tonight and he doesn't think he'll be back in time to kiss Kim tomorrow.
Mama, why didn't you tell me this before?
I tried to, sweetheart. But you kept bringing up a certain party from south of the border.
What's he thinking? He knows how much this means to me. Conrad.
No. Take it easy, Albert. I'm coming. Before you start hollering, I just want you to know. Made up my mind. Tired of waking up at 9 every morning, having people watch me when I eat, and little kids poking me in the eye. I want to have some fun. Go out, meet a couple of young chicks. Don't you understand, Albert? I am tense.
Don't just stand there. Do something. Not that.
Oh, Conrad! Oh. Did you ever think in terms of a more mature woman?
Man, I hope I never get that tense. Now look, buddy boy, this is my last free night before I go out in the army, and I am going out.
Not without my permission, you're not. It says so in your contract. Mama, get the contract. Never mind. I'll get it myself. Conrad, stay here.
Conrad!
There are chicks just right for some kissing, and I mean to kiss me a few. Man, those chicks
don't know what they're missing. I've got a lot of living to do. Sizzling steaks, all ready for tasting. And there's Cadillacs, all shiny and new. Gotta move, 'cause time is wasting. There's such a lot of living to do.
There are men of 19 or 20 who are suave and reckless and true. Older men who'll give a girl plenty. I got a lot of living to do.
There's music to play, places to go, people to see. Everything for you and me. Hey, you chicks live here, don't you?
Yes, Mr. Birdie.
So, what's the lowdown on this town?
Sweet Apple, Ohio was founded in 1852 by Jeremiah S. Apple.
No, I mean, what do you do here? Where do you go to have a ball?
Well, there's the church basement and the sweet shop. And the older kids go to the ice house.
Ice house? What's that?
I don't know. Ice, I guess.
The ice house, Mr. Birdie, is where people go when they want to be... alone.
Hey, ain't you the chick I was supposed to kiss?
I am not a chick. I am a fully grown woman, and I insist on being treated as such. In fact, that is why I have left home.
Hey, now you're talking chick. Let's move. We got things to do. Crazy clothes and motorboat races.
Someone nice to cuddle up to. Broadway lines and wide open spaces. There's such a lot of living to do. Lots of things, and no one to scold you. Look at you and laugh at the view. Moonlight's weird.
Places to go, people to see. Everything for you and me.
Kim, where are you? Hugo,
Have you seen Kim?
Don't ask me. Ask Conrad Birdie.
What are you talking about?
Well, they're off together having moonlight swims and motorboat races and loop the loop. I'm gonna do the only sensible thing. Drink myself to death.
Moonlight swims? Motorboat races? Loop the loop! Doris! Get my gun!
Mr. McAfee, you haven't seen Conrad, have you?
No, but I intend on seeing him, Mr. Peterson. So if you have a message for him, I'll be glad to deliver it for you. Right after I shoot him.
Shoot him? Rosie, I gotta find Rosie.
Dear, what are you talking about? You know we don't have a gun.
There's that Daisy air rifle in the garage.
That's mine, Pa.
You shut up. I wonder where I can buy BBs this late at night.
Anyways, dear, I think it's broken.
Well, get me anything then. There's that bow and arrow I bought you last Christmas. The one with the suction tips. Well, don't just stand there. My daughter's gone off to loop the loop with a fiend. Get me a water gun. Kids, I don't know what's wrong with these kids today. Kids who can understand anything they say. Kids, they are disobedient, disrespectful loafs. Noisy, crazy, sloppy, lazy loafers. And while we're on the subject, kids, you can talk and talk till your face is blue. Kids, but they still do just what they want to do. Why can't they be like we were, perfect in every way? What's the matter with kids today? Kids! I don't mind the moonlight swims. It's the loop that kills. Kids! Why don't they just lower the draft age to about 11? Kids! I didn't know what puberty was until I was almost past it. Kids, they are just impossible to control. Kids, with their awful clothes and their rock and roll. Why can't they dance like we dance? What's wrong with Sammy K?
Hey, Pa, here's my pea shooter.
A pea shooter?
Yep.
What good's a... Give it to me. What's the matter with kids today?
I'll have a double rocks on the scotch. And put some rocks at this time. Can you make me a vodka malted?
How old are you?
32.
Get out.
Well, what about a beer?
Beat it!
Can't I just sit here with an empty glass in front of me?
Out.
I demand to see the manager. Where's Maud?
I am Mudd.
I'm Charles F. Mudd.
And if you're not out of here in 1 minute, I'll take you by the scruff of the neck and throw you out.
All right, I'm going. Well, this is the last time I do my drinking in this bar.
Double bourbon. Scotch on the side, no ice, and put a cherry in it. Make that 2 cherries, and bring on the dancing boys. Alvarez is the name, but I want you to call me Spanish Rose, Cibonet. Da 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 da.
Spanish Rose.
See?
Get out.
Now wait a minute. You can't throw me out. I'm an American citizen, and it is my constitutional right to have a drink here if I so choose.
Yeah.
And get loaded here
yeah.
if I so
this
choose.
This is Albert Peterson.
And do any manner
is Rose Alvarez
and trashy
there?
Things here if I so choose. This is Spanish Rose's coming out party.
Who?
And when I say coming out,
Rose
I
Alvarez.
Mean coming out.
In like fact, I think that's her voice like I hear in the background.
Hey, Fidel Castro. There is a guy named Peterson that wants to talk to you.
Tell that weaselly little rat I'm not here.
Aha! That proves she's there. Who else knows I'm a weaselly little rat? Rose, I gotta talk to you. It's about Conrad.
And furthermore, even if I were this Rose, which I am not, the one thing that would make me hang up this phone is any mention of anyone named Conrad.
Rose, please don't hang up. I won't mention Conrad. We can talk about anything you want. You, me, I, anything. Oh, Rose, please.
Talk to me, baby, won't you talk to me? I don't care what you say, baby, talk to me. Must you be, oh, so far away from me? It seems all wrong this way. Talk to me. And if you miss me, tell me so. Are you lonely? Tell me so. Say you love me. Tell me so, honey.
Rose, are you alone?
No, I'm not alone, Albert. I'm with friends. See you later, boys.
See you later, boys? Rose, you gotta help me find Conrad.
That's just the beginning, Albert. From now on, it's going to be parties, balls, dances. Emma Polo, my pretty Emma. Oh. Hey, what's going on in there?
No business of yours, lady.
It's a private dining room.
Well, private for whom?
For men only. That's for whom?
Men only. Well, that's exactly what I've been looking for. I know what goes on in these small towns. Out of Spanish Rose's
way.
Hey, wait,
wait.
Somebody stop her.
Wait.
Come
back here.
Hey, Mama, get my coat.
Thank you.
secretary reads the minutes of last week's meeting, I'd like to bring up a subject I am sure is on everyone's mind tonight.
Alvarez, can you do me a favor? Could you go back in there and give me some grain alcohol to go?
Oh, not for $1 million.
But my whole world is collapsing before me. I can't get a drink in it. Kim's run off with Conrad to the ice house.
Kim and Conrad? They've gone to the ice house? Albert, I've got to phone Albert. Hugo, you stay right there. Oh, Albert.
It's Mart. Mama, hurry.
I don't see why we have to go running around all night looking for someone it would be better not to find in the first place. If you listen to me, Sonny, you'll come home, have a nice cup of Ovaltine, and go to bed.
I already told you, Mama, I'm not leaving until I find Rosie.
Now, if you want to leave, that's okay with me. In fact, that's not a bad idea. Why don't you go home, Mama?
What did you say, sweetheart, darling?
I said, why don't you go home, Mama?
Would you mind repeating that once more, sunshine of my existence?
I said go home, Mama. I don't need you anymore.
So, it's coming back. At last it's come. The day I knew would come at least has come at last. My sonny boy doesn't need me anymore. Well, what are you waiting for? Get rid of me. Just put me out with the garbage. Throw me out with the used grapefruits and empty cans from the Bumblebee salmon. Never mind putting a lid on. Leave it open so 100,000 pussycats can walk all over a mother. And by the way, sweetheart, I got some good news for you. I got the report from the hospital. It's absolutely definite. I got a condition. Never mind what kind of condition. A condition. And the one thing doctors can't cure is a condition. I don't want you to worry, though. Fancy funerals are for rich people. I don't want you to spend a cent. Just wait till Mother's Day. Wrap me in a flag and dump me in the river. Well, I feel better now. Everything is as it should be. A mother is lying on top of a sanitation truck bound for the city dump. And the son is running around in saloons with a Mexicali Rose, who came over for the fruit picking season and stayed to ruin an American woman's life.
Are you finished, Mama?
Yes, son boy.
Night, Mama.
You're just like your father. You'd marry anything.
My name is not Sonny Boy.
Good night, Albert!
Mr. Have you seen Conrad and Kim?
Mr. McAfee, it's a pleasure to see you again. Unfortunately, Conrad's affairs no longer concern me, but I am looking for Miss Al... Did you say Conrad and Kim?
They've run off together.
And if I don't find them soon, Mr. Peterson, I intend on calling the FBI. Who's the head of that now, dear? Is it Peter Lawford yet?
Oh, no, now relax. I'm sure everything's fine.
Oh, yes. Harry! Have you seen Ursula?
Ursula?
Is she missing too?
Since 10 o'clock, and I've looked everywhere.
Mr. Peterson! You haven't seen my Harvey's, have you?
Really? Now relax. I'm sure they're all just down at the drugstore. Maybe having one of those gang wars.
Oh, God. Gang wars?
I don't see why anybody wants them.
Just you wait and
kids,
see.
They're just impossible to
soon
control.
You'll be old enough to
kids, with their awful clothes and their rock
another
and roll.
Another teenage delinquent.
Why can't they be like you were, perfect in every way?
What is the matter with kids? Two kids, what the devil's wrong is kids today. Kids.
Rio and Greed. Gosh, I'll never forget that wonderful cast. Dolores del Rio
and Gene Raymond.
And what a score!
I've forgotten that. Hey, Rio, flying down to Rio.
Rose, where you been? I've been looking for you all night. Listen, Rose, I got some great news. I did it. I sent Mama home. I'm a new man, Rose, a world leader.
Albert, Kim and Conrad have gone to the ice house together.
The ice house? The ice house? Doris, call the mountain police. Call Mr. Keene, tracer of lost persons. Call the shadow. Look him up under Lamont Cranston.
Oh, or how about one of
You know, I've heard so much about them. You know, I could get you a fix if you just tell me what one is. When you've had a donkey on your back as long as I have, you know, it's... Oh, Conrad, you're trembling. You know, just because you're a few years younger than me, I really hope it doesn't make you feel uncomfortable. I'm 27 or 28, one of the two. So, you know, I really know the score. I even know some of the words. Can you be in? Pre-marital jailbait!
There you are! Oh, sensuous one! We've been looking for you everywhere!
That's nice. Now out of my way, I'm late. Wasn't as much fun as I made it out to be.
And we need to start right now. Let's have a party!
And I'll go down to the courthouse and try to talk to the mayor.
Rose, I guess you didn't understand what I said before. This is the new Al Peterson.
But Albert, I'm just trying.
Don't butt Albert me, Rose. You are merely woman. I am man. Woman's job is to clean the house and obey and speak only when she is spake to. My first command for you, woman, is to get our bags and be down at the train station at 6:30 tomorrow morning, where we will meet Conrad. I further command you to bring all necessary documents, because I intend on making you Mrs. Albert Peterson by 2400 hours tomorrow. Roger, over and out. Rose, did I mention that I loved you?
Not yet, Albert.
Well, I do. Conrad!
It's gonna be such a wonderful life. I'm gonna be Mrs. Peterson. Mrs. Albert Peterson. Mrs. Phi Beta Kappa Peterson.
Oh, Rosie, nothing can stop you now.
Hello, Rose!
Hello, May.
So, we're alone at last. Have you a minute to spare for a heart-to-heart with an old friend?
Well, I'll always have time to talk with the woman who by tomorrow evening I'll be able to call.
Don't say it, Rose!
I'll be able to call Mother.
The cruelest word I ever heard. To think I've lived to see the day I have relatives in El Salvador!
Oh, and not to mention Guatemala, Chile, Uruguay, and Chichicastenango. And May, as soon as Albert and I are married, I'm going to stick out rolls in my teeth, sit out in front of my adobe hut on Central Park West, and sell tortillas. Adios, Mama.
Adios, Rosita.
Call me Mrs. Peterson. I'm just a Spanish tamale according to me. Right off the boat from the tropics far, far away. Which is kind of funny, since where I come from is Allentown, PA. Spanish, okay, may I be Spanish. Just wait till I marry Alberto. I'll be the cocho tiki castanango. And all day long my castanets will click. I'll hide behind my fan and do the tango. I'll be so Spanish it will make you sick. I'll eat the tacos and the enchilada. I'll drink tequila till I feel no pain. The only song I sing will be Granada. I'll be more Espanol than Abby Lane. So call me the wild Spanish rose, the craziest flower that grows. I'll kick up my heels and see how it feels to be sultry Spanish rose. You buy my tortilla. You like me, yes. No? Maybe? Americano, let me give you a bit of advice. To cross Spanish roads isn't twice. Your match you have found, so don't mess around. Her heart, she is cold like ice. With Albert, I will dance to the bolero. We'll cha-cha in the nicest honky-tonks. He'll wear a little mustache and sombrero. My handsome Latin lover from the Bronx. So now that you've met Spanish Rose, you'll never forget Spanish Rose. She'll taunt you, she'll tame you, but what man could blame you for worshipping Spanish Rose? Not Danish, not British, not Swedish, not Yiddish, but Spanish Rose.
All right, there's nobody here. Come on.
Now, hold on, Albert.
Shut up and get on that train. It took every cent I had to bail you out, and I'm not going to have you seen until you're out of the state.
Now, wait a minute, Albert. You saved my life, and whether that pays no guarantee to you or not, you have a contract with me for life.
Conrad, what are you saying?
Here's a piece of paper I signed my name to. Just fill in whatever you want.
Hello, Albert. Mama!
Mama,
now,
Now, Mama, would you stop this nonsense and get on the train? God.
I demand to know what you've done with Mr. Birdie. He's not in that jail.
Well, how should I know where he is? I haven't seen him all night. I'm just here saying goodbye to Rosie.
Mr. Peterson!
Oh, now, dear, there's no point in getting upset. After all, there's no real harm done. Kim and Hugo are back together again. And as a matter of fact, the sweetest thing happened. He proposed to her this morning, and she accepted him. What's the matter? What's wrong?
My life is over. I think I'll sell the house and go into a home.
Where's the train?
Left at 6:25.
But Albert, you told me to be here at 6...
With Conrad.
6:30 sharp, I know, because
you... And Mama.
Albert, you wanted us to miss that train?
It stands to reason, Rose. Why go to New York when you have two tickets to Pumpkin Falls, Iowa?
Well, what's in Pumpkin Falls, Iowa?
A teaching job in the staff of the Pumpkin Falls Junior High School. I read about it today in the paper. They want someone to teach English and domestic science. And I hope you brought your papers, Rose, because they prefer the applicant to be married.
Oh, Albert!
Rose, did anyone ever tell you that that's the most beautiful name in the world? I was never crazy for flowers. I confess that nothing left me colder. I could watch a daisy for hours, and all I'd feel was several hours older. Lilacs or lilies, any bloom you please. All that they did was make me shrug or sneeze. But now I love each blossom that I see, for a lovely little rose loves me. Now my life is rosy, since I found my Rosie. With a girl like Rosie, how could I be blue? Hand in hand we'll mosey, me and little Rosie. We will be so cozy by a fire built for two. Oh, I once heard a poem that goes, a rose is a rose is a rose. But I don't agree, take it from me. This one rose sweeter than any that grows, and that's my Rosie. I'm so glad she chose me. Life is one sweet, beautiful song to me. Now my life is rosy.
Oh, happy I know.
Since I found my Rosie.
Off to preacher we'll go.
With a girl like Rosie.
So how could we be?
How could I be blue?
Have us a home out west, a nice little split level nest, and in every room roses in bloom.
But there's one rose sweeter than all of the rest, and that's my Rosie.
I'm so glad you chose me.
Life is one sweet, beautiful song. When love is right, then what could be wrong? Life is one sweet, beautiful song to me.